Yeah, yeah. DMV, you know what time it is. None other than the Baseline Podcast presented by The Everyday Weekend. I am your host as always, Capo. Feeling good, feeling great. To the left of me as always, my good man and young Mitchell We Trust. What's good, buddy?
What's good? How you living?
Man, you a whole coder.
I am.
A whole coder.
Absolutely.
Hey, fella, the beer. Don't tease me. Give me the beer.
He forgot who asked what? For it.
Oh, thanks, sir. I saw it. I was like, what's going on? Is this a joke? Happy to be a quarter?
Yes.
Happy birthday, sir.
Thank you, sir.
We are definitely getting to your weekend, but we're going to swing it because this part of your weekend is right next to you. Goddamn.
Oh, part of the weekend.
Goddamn M.R.
I am
Anderson,
a part of the weekend.
Apparently.
The everyday
I knew that's what you was going to do. No.
That was cute, but that is not what I mean.
You ain't fucking shit. This nigga ain't shit.
This nigga full of it. Yo. Mr. Anderson, how are you, sir?
What's good? What's good, man?
Did you learn a new quote or anything out there?
Nope.
Yep.
Nah. He ain't come here with shit.
I did some business. We can't talk
about it. You see how he switched that shit over?
But yeah, we did some business.
Not what I asked you. Yeah. Swinging it right on around.
All
right. The good man, K900.
Mike check 1212.
You ain't shit.
Indeed.
Now I get the pound. Yeah. All right, I'm feeling.
I had to get one more out.
Hey, don't be excited about a pound like that. I'm feeling it.
It's cool.
I like it. It made me nervous.
Cool.
All right, guys. So, what happened with the video? Video's processed. Okay, close. Anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So speaking of which, wait, what am I doing? I'm going too fast. Last but certainly not least, Jesus Christ. This is why I need him up on his perch.
Right? Hey. You gotta get the DJ, son.
We gotta get the boss tool, man.
Yeah, man. I need my man in this.
You sit on the chair, too.
Nah, man. Yeah, is that comfortable for an hour?
Probably not.
All right,
cool.
You got a backrest and all that.
All right, we got it.
All right. The good man, last but certainly not least, my apologies. The good man, DJ P Knox in the building.
Yes, sir.
Now it's official. My apologies, my good man.
It's all good, man.
Nah. Damn. Knock had a weekend, too, though.
Wait a minute. Don't deflect.
You see how this nigga doing, bro?
I don't know. I'm sicing shit right now.
Deflection.
I'm sicing everything.
Deflection will get you nowhere.
Sicing everything. Nature boy.
Hey, bro.
Nature, how are you, sir? You good? All right, good.
Oh no, he great.
Yeah, he looks sensational. He looks like a great day. And Captain Slips is in the building too. Good people. Roz Arai on the camera.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
Brittany on the stuff in the face.
Yeah.
Goddamn, the roads are here.
Lit.
Yeah.
Yes, so we having a sense. Oh, and let's not forget Captain Louis in the building.
Oh, Captain Louis here.
Louis. Louis. What's good? You all right? All right, cool. Just had to make sure. All right, so gentlemen, we're gonna start with the Middlemen's weekend.
Okay.
Gentlemen went to Las Vegas, and I know what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. Did you? Way to telling yourself. Did you guys have a good time?
I had a great time.
All right, Tim, we're going to talk about your weekend primarily because it was your birthday. You turned a whole quarter.
100%.
Yes. Happy for you.
Yeah.
So, first time in Vegas, correct?
Yes, it was my first time in Vegas.
All right, so was it lit?
Yeah, it was fun. I think we got a condensed version of it because, you know, we're still getting back from...
It's always great to start like that.
Can you swing that bit? What? Thank you, sir.
Bet.
But yeah, train, choo choo choo.
But yeah, no, I think it was a good start, a good introduction to Vegas. You
okay,
know?
Okay.
Didn't get too out of hand, but
you said two out of hand.
Mm-hmm.
Two out of hand. So something got out of hand because you said it didn't get two out of hand.
Without saying too much.
So hold up. First off,
good observation.
Where'd y'all stay at? Y'all stayed at.
My man on the.
I ain't get the. Come to your hotel.
We stayed at the Venetian.
That's nice.
That was nice.
Yeah, it was really nice.
Oh shit, that's me.
Well rounded.
Like, yeah, it was. The only thing I didn't like about it was
I didn't know if it was a bomb or what. I was concerned.
We couldn't use the refrigerator.
Yeah, I couldn't use the.
Why not?
Okay,
because it was fully stocked.
Oh yeah, yeah. Once you touch that shit,
it was weight sensor.
Mm-hmm.
So if you open that hoe,
no. If you let's say you opened it, but then you know you're parched. You know you want a bottle of water.
Huh.
That's $10 out your account.
Easy.
Oh, right. Could you put water in it?
Jeez. No.
Oh, that's a bullshit refrigerator.
Dang, they got the
technology. It's motion. It's weight sensor. She did.
Yeah, definitely.
It was weight sensor. So like, if you touch it and lift it up,
yeah,
they're going to charge you for it.
Yeah, they're going to expect
you. But what if you put a water in there? Is what I'm saying.
You can possibly put a water in there,
like just to chill it.
Like on.
Oh no, you couldn't even use it at all. There was a $150 fee to even use it.
Oh no, fuck that.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That's crazy.
Hang that shit up.
So that's why you had to get a bucket of ice, right?
Wait.
You gotta get a bucket of ice and put the water in the ice.
We got a whole cooler.
Come on. You ain't know.
I'm not trying to escape anything.
No, you know. Come on, let us know.
So next, I think
I like that energy. So
yeah, y'all went to the desert, right?
Yeah.
You hear this, nigga?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Nah, y'all went to the desert. Y'all rode the.
Yeah, we did ATV riding. Okay, that was my birthday activity.
Mm.
We did ATV riding.
How'd you like that?
It was dope. It was cool. It was where we went riding at is where they filmed like a few scenes from Casino. So that was pretty cool.
Oh shit, that's all right.
Yeah.
Y'all got to open them up a little bit?
Not
so much.
Towards the end. Okay. Towards the end. Okay. So yeah, but not.
Indeed.
Tim, you making this sound real tame. Were there women in Las Vegas?
This
is
what I'm saying. Yeah, I'm trying to get to the shit.
There was women there. There was a woman there. Artisanal woman.
The not too wild? It wasn't too wild.
You know how you ease into things? It was like everything wasn't even really open for real. So like, oh, funny story. So we were trying to go to a club on Saturday night, right?
All right. Now we getting somewhere.
So, you know, on the Eventbrite, it said text this number, get your name on the guest list.
Right on.
And so it was like for $20 per person, you get entry in and you get a little table situation.
Sounds suspicious.
No, $20 a person and a table.
Yeah, I was like, this doesn't sound right.
It sounds right about that shit.
Yeah, go ahead.
Huh? No, everybody at the table pays $20 and you get it.
But how big is this table?
I don't know.
A minimum.
So,
they were sitting at a king's table. How they making money?
That's what I was trying to figure out. Yeah. I was like, this doesn't make sense. But all right, we'll just keep on.
Trucking?
Yeah. So
see what it's about.
So I text the number, give him my name, and then I gave him the amount of people I was coming with.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And he's like, all right, cool, that's a bet. Here are your options. Cool. So I said, okay, bet, we're gonna go here. We're pulling up there. So that's confirmation that we're going, correct?
Yeah. No,
it's not.
Kinda.
Good, yeah.
Because he asked me, are we coming? And I said yes.
You're talking
we are
to
pulling
the,
up.
To
I'm
the
talking
host,
to the
host guy.
The person who I was communicating
whatever.
With.
Okay.
Okay.
He was like, are you guys coming? I said, yes, we are pulling up.
Okay.
And then
you sent money?
No, I didn't send money.
Oh, okay.
I wasn't gonna send
you didn't purchase anything.
He didn't tell me where I was gonna send it to.
He did not. Okay.
Okay.
So that I'm not saying you needed to purchase something.
I don't know. The shit.
But I don't feel like you had a guarantee yet.
This shit just sounds shaky.
Yeah,
this shit.
I don't feel like you had a guarantee at anything.
Yeah, no, I agree with you on that. It's not a guarantee until you send money.
Nah.
It just sounded like you communicated.
But go ahead.
Hey, I'm gonna pull up.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
That doesn't even sound concrete.
Yeah. Go ahead.
And he might not even know that slang. You know what I'm saying?
I know. In hindsight, like the next day, I was like, he probably doesn't even know what this means.
Yeah.
Right.
But
go ahead.
So then an hour later, he said, okay, cool. And then an hour later, I text him, said, is there a dress code or anything? Because, I would hate to get there and then not get in.
Mm-hmm. You might have
thought it
up. And then. Yeah, for sure.
But no, this was during the daytime we were getting this situated. It wasn't at night.
So I'm still very confused. But go on.
So then he said, I asked him for the dress code. And then he said, we're sold out.
Okay.
And I was like, damn, I just told you I was coming.
I know what that was.
That's a play.
Yeah. It was too much questioning, I think.
He was asking more questions than me.
No, I get it. But I'm just saying, like, by that time, he was just like, man, fuck it. I'm about to get rid of this shit. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
And if you hit him closer to the time of the duration of you pulling up, then he didn't. Talk to multiple other people that confirmed.
What that was for though?
What?
It was a lesson.
For your first trip.
Yeah,
you know what to do the next time.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Not
don't dilly-dally.
Yeah.
Indeed.
I wasn't even weird. I just asked questions.
Indeed.
I had no problem.
So I didn't go to the club, and then what happened?
We ended up going to downtown Vegas.
Okay.
What's in downtown?
The old town.
Oh yeah. So
like the old town.
Oh, we get filthy over there.
Down at the bottom of the strip.
It wasn't even
bottom of the strip.
But yeah, nah. It was just
shit cheaper.
Yeah, that's all it was. It was just the bets at the casinos were cheaper.
Okay.
And yeah. I want some money.
You had it come up.
Wait, hold up.
He had it come up.
Yeah, I did.
Go ahead.
Listen. But go ahead.
What?
He had it come up.
He told me he wants some money.
Yeah, he wants some money.
He texted me about it.
Right? So I did.
It was about.
Nah.
He ain't do it. If this nigga sent me a money phone, I'd have like called him on FaceTime. Like, what the fuck is going on?
But, I would have looked like a lick if I would have did that.
So, no, this is what happens. So, he hits me. It's like 1:20 last night. No, Sunday night.
Okay.
So, Sunday night, 1 a.m. Mm-hmm. Or what is that?
Morning.
Saturday night going into Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
That's what it was. So, he hits me. It's 1:15, which is 10:15 his time. So, it's not crazy late or nothing. And he goes, I just won some money at a table with some artisanal Indian women. And then he says, tell wifey I said, thanks. That's it.
All right. That's wow. All
right. So I didn't respond, right? Because I didn't see it. Not because, like, I was asleep.
Yeah.
So I wake up to it and I'm like, oh, that's lit. He's having a good time, right? So then he texts me today and I ain't heard from him since he sent that, right? And he goes, I was going to ask you something, but I just looked at the last thing I sent you and that's wild. And I was like, yeah, it is. But wifey said, you're welcome. And then he goes, yeah, man, I came up. You know, he told me he wants some money, woo, woo, woo. And then I was like, well, you know what I'm saying? You hit it off with one of them, you know what I'm saying? You know, of course me, I'm like, you know what I'm saying? You get the sample, see something, woo, woo. He like, oh, no, they were like grandmas. So then I was like, oh, so you like older, like women? Like, what's going on?
I do like older
but like harder. That much older?
Nah, that was a little out of my age range, my age bracket.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what's your age bracket?
Longevity.
There we go. Like, you could wait for it to hit that motherfucker. No? This thing's crazy. Yeah.
I'm equal opportunity with drums when they available. True.
Just pointing out shit.
He is very fair.
I see what you did.
What's your age bracket?
I like to model myself after Kaz. Uh-huh. Like a little Freaky 45, that's like the cutoff.
Say that again.
Freaky 45.
Yeah, go ahead, man. I want to make sure everybody hears.
Yeah, all right.
Go ahead, let them know.
I like that he included the freaky part.
Right now.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what it is. That's the name of the song.
Yeah.
No, that is the name of the song, but you could have just been like, I like causes.
No,
you
know, that's what
perception
I'm saying.
Of a cutoff.
Nah, I like that he said that.
Nah,
yeah, go ahead.
Because then people will be looking for the song, and then it's like, is this easier if you just give them the song title?
I think if you put in cause 45, it's going to work out.
Nah, it might autocorrect to Cole 45.
Look, you
Freaky 45. Let me explain something to
you. You better off telling them how to spell his name than telling them that it's Freaky 45 on the search. Guaranteed.
That's fair.
Yeah. So you cut the bullshit, sir. What's up with you and the grandmas? What happened?
Nah,
I feel like that was deflection, like you took one of them home.
Nah, I didn't. I think one was trying to, but I just wasn't.
What, so why not? Was they not 45?
Nah, they were older than that. It just wasn't. It wasn't a good look.
It was out of the range.
It wasn't a good look.
It's probably out of the range.
No, what was it though?
Did you not
estimate,
have the lingo?
Estimate.
You ain't had a lingo for them.
The lingo for them?
Mm-hmm.
What was her age?
Yeah.
She was probably like, she looked like she was around my mother's age. So like 60.
Mm.
Oh yeah?
Yes, that's out
she
of the age.
She okay.
Ooh. You probably could have.
Look. You don't know what to say now.
You probably could have got some extra chips. Like shit.
He could.
Like
you're
shit.
Right, yeah. She went to his room and left some chips on the nightstand.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Right next to her dentures.
She gets up at 4 a.m. regardless.
Happy birthday, Timmy. That's what she would have said.
Happy birthday, Timmy.
Hey. Oh. It's all good though.
Hey, bro. Never mind. I'm not gonna ask
it's
you.
It's all good though.
I got a wild question.
All good though.
Go ahead, take it there.
Nah,
all right,
so you made some money on the strip, the old town strip.
Yeah.
And then y'all just took it back into the hotel.
Bruh. Yeah.
And then you met up with me Sunday.
Yeah. So what was crazy is we were also stranded out there too.
What do you mean stranded?
Because there was a there's an Uber shortage. in Las Vegas.
So what the fuck that mean?
That means that we were
limited Ubers.
There's limited Ubers.
So y'all were just stuck where?
They were Uberless.
In Old Town Vegas for 2 hours waiting on an Uber.
Oh yeah, that's, Jesus. That's when it was time.
And
it
wasn't no taxis around?
Oh, huh? God.
It wasn't no taxis around, nothing?
Nah.
Y'all weren't trying to ride no taxi?
No, we rode in a taxi, but it wasn't.
Yeah, I could have started walking back.
We probably should have walked back because it was only like a 10-minute drive.
Did y'all even think about calling a taxi?
Nah, we didn't.
Bro, you have fucking computers in your hands, and y'all sat there right. And was like, we're just going to wait 2 hours.
Yeah, you got to think. Taxis, you
know. Jesus Christ. What I'm saying is
taxis are cheaper. I got one of my taxi.
No, they're not.
Right
taxis are now. Not cheaper.
Yes, they are not. Out there,
bro. Man, when they picked us, when we used a taxi,
I got my man number
to
right
get
now.
From the hotel. No, from the airport to the hotel. Mm. That shit was like $30 for like a 10-minute ride.
Yeah, now they gonna bust your ass.
But
that
taxis
way.
Will yeah. be cheaper. They are cheaper
but
than
then,
Ubers.
But
you in town, yeah.
But then when
how
I
hot was it though? How hot was it?
It was nighttime, so it was like 70 degrees.
Yeah, I would have definitely then, walked. I would have definitely walked.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, you could have walked.
But yeah, I mean, but then we
or
just
at least got a head start.
But yeah, we just went back and got
took
food and
right.
Indeed.
Played some more
man,
machine
be
games.
The best food
so
in
so
Vegas,
basically,
yeah.
This trip was just to scope out the scene. Next trip, you gonna take it there?
You're gonna be
yeah.
on fire.
Dropped a couple pins as
gonna be on fire.
Okay,
Mr. Coppage would say.
Yeah. Okay.
No. Don't ever refer to me that way.
Why? You wouldn't drop it.
Because when I drop a pin, I go back to it. You can't leave the state and then, like, that's not how that works. I drop a pin in the spot.
What if it's a lasting impression?
And then I come back to the pin.
Mm.
What if it's a lasting impression?
Did you get the number?
Nah.
Then it. Did you get the IG? What'd you get?
I did get a few IGs.
I got a few IGs. You hear this whippersnapper? All right,
that's a light pin. That's a
this
light
shit
pin.
Crazy.
But don't make pin dropping sound like it's a like multi-state, multi-week deal. That's not how that works.
I got a few IGs.
It's not a bundle?
No, you drop the pin in your lap.
Uh-huh.
And then you assess which pin to attack.
Uh-oh. Got you. Okay. Learning more lessons.
Uh-huh. More lessons.
Yeah, you can't just leave the pin for 3 weeks and cool. then be like, oh, the pin should still be where I left it. No, the pin's living life too.
Gotcha.
You
get what I'm saying? You're like, come on, son.
Yeah.
All right, man, let's get to these topics, bro.
No, we missed it. There's another.
Oh, wait, no. Oh,
No.
I like that.
Where y'all going?
Hey,
my apologies. Where you in a rush?
So, Tim, during your expedition in the desert,
yeah,
you saw a
familiar face.
A Anderson in the wild.
Bruh.
Hello.
It was wading in the water, shimmying its shoulders.
Shimmying hard, too, man.
Oh, my goodness.
To return of the Mac.
Yeah, crazy.
Very lonely in the
crazy.
Pool, in solitude.
And then I also
looking
heard.
Looking very, very old.
I also heard that he
what
happened
you mean,
to take
old?
Laps.
Hold you
up,
look like
up,
an
hold.
Old ass nigga
no,
in that pool
I,
doing
no,
that.
I didn't that.
Yes, you did.
Nah, you did.
When?
You look
did.
Like
y'all seen what?
You was an uncle ass nigga.
Oh, you won solo video?
You was the yeah. uncle
oh,
ass nigga right. in that
so
pool.
So y'all ain't see the other shit. Oh, I bet.
John.
That's cool. Because the other shit wasn't to see.
Yeah. Cool. I chose wisely.
Cool. Thank you.
All you're I'm welcome. Saying is in that clip, you look like Uncle Anderson.
All right, cool. That's cool. I'm cool with that. Because I am that.
I
literally.
Also heard this nigga took laps in a Vegas pool.
No, he's not.
And what was it, 3 feet?
Hmm?
You said three or four
I
feet?
I said four.
Yes, he does.
Four feet.
It was 4 feet.
4 feet laps.
Because I wanted to, you know what I'm saying, get my stroke on.
He wanted, oh. This.
I want to get my stroke on real quick.
This nigga's crazy.
I can't believe you did laps. First of all, how do you swim in 3 feet of water?
What do you mean, underwater?
Right, but I would be scraping my hands on the bottom
did
of the
pool.
No. I ain't scraping.
He definitely has some bruises.
I didn't have no underwater.
I don't got no bruises.
You did your laps
this nigga was doing
too?
Laps
nah, I just,
in a
I just
swimming pool
took a little,
of 3 feet of water.
From here
partial piss.
To here. That's it. I did it. And then I walked back.
Hey.
And talk to the lovely ladies along
oh,
the way.
That's what you were doing. You were showing you could swim and shit.
Was it
he's
that?
Like,
I'm like,
it sounded like he acted like nothing happened.
Hey, it's a pool. Ain't nobody else swimming. Fuck it.
Yeah, there's a reason. It's 3 feet of water.
It's four.
Anyway, so
Tim was standing up in it. He was cool.
Yeah, that's cool. I mean, I know
about wait, 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 wait. Don't do that.
Why are you taking shots at me?
I'm not taking shots.
Why did I catch a stray?
He said that shit like you 3'9". Yeah. Like, what the fuck? Nah. He's good in 4 feet of water.
Say Till was standing,
he's
man.
Good in
it was
5
cool.
feet of water.
You feel like I'm fucking Earl Boykins or some shit. Like,
he's good in 5. He's good in 5. He's good in 5. He's good in 5.
5 is up to his neck almost.
But he's good.
Hey,
John act like he's 6'2".
I'm not saying that.
John like 3 inches taller than me.
You said what?
The whole thing. He's
I don't even think you're that much taller than Tim.
I'm not. But I know how to swim. I know how to swim. See, that's where you was trying to get me to go. I wasn't trying to go there.
He didn't tell me that. You ain't even tell him we could swim. What are you doing? I didn't want to tell him. I should have him out there.
Thanks to
Peanut. Mr. Peanut.
He's a dirty dog.
He said he'd just stay in the kiddie pool.
Thanks to Peanut. I'm just saying. Hey, but look. Tim pulled up. I had the situation. We was lit, right?
Yeah, it was good. It was fun. It was nice to see Sid. Haven't seen Sid since.
I found out that
Ash has the same birthday as me.
You didn't know that?
Same day.
I did not. Damn, that's because y'all was talking about your
mimosa. They thought they was close. They didn't know it was the actual same day, though.
My mimosa is addiction.
Oh, Lord.
Yo, I really can't believe.
I don't know.
I think you said you didn't tell me her birthday. You just said Sid is going to be in Portland at the same time.
With his wife.
For his wife's birthday.
Facts.
They were there for multiple days. It could have been any day.
It could have been. But yeah, nah.
She really ate that story up. It's mind-boggling how your storytelling abilities.
It's true.
But to a certain extent.
It was a good situation. We was right poolside. We was right here poolside. We had
right here? We got a pool.
Couple bottles and shit. Yeah. We had some.
Can we get a pool? Let's get a pool.
What else we get?
Is that in the budget?
We had
we'll make one.
Like free chicken tenders and wings.
Free chicken tenders. That's all right, cuz.
Free chicken tenders, wings, and fries.
This sounds like the blackest event in Vegas.
Yeah, you niggas was balling out.
I feel like one
was that watermelon too?
That was surprising.
Hey, those slices of the little balls.
No. No watermelon. Y'all are crazy.
John was in that.
Nah, it would have been love if we could have had fruit.
Yeah, see, watermelon. Yeah,
but
what?
You see watermelon. This nigga
come
hit.
On, man.
But nah, it was a good situation. Pretty pricey, but it worked out.
Baller Anderson showed
up. Man.
It worked out.
Big Baller Anderson.
We glad y'all made it back in one piece, man.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, if y'all got sunglasses on, you in for a show.
he had his glasses on.
If he got shades on, it's
you thought he was going to the desert time. Without his eyes protected?
Oh, what you had? You have
yeah, no,
Cartier,
he got a protective retina.
Cartier frame.
My Cartiers? Nah, I left those.
What'd
you do?
I brought the Gucci.
See, I knew he wasn't going. He wasn't going not tell
y'all
you.
Y'all crazy. Yeah.
He wasn't going not tell you. He just needed to build anticipation. Yeah,
I wasn't going not.
No,
tell
but you. But the way you said it is what I'm saying. You I had to bet. Build anticipation. It's okay. I appreciate the showmanship.
Indeed.
I just want you to own it.
Hey, but look. On a side note.
Here you go.
Hey, the Raiders Stadium.
Yeah.
That joint lit.
Can I ask you a question?
Did you go inside?
No, I didn't go. I haven't got no VIP status for that yet. But that joint looked like it's like all glass. Like they just placed that shit there.
Yeah.
Like not built.
Yeah, it definitely looks
placed.
Like, because we drove past it.
Seen it on the way, right?
It definitely looks out of place.
It's crazy. That joint crazy. That shit hard.
Tim, you know what I asked you about? What's MITMonday gonna be? You don't gotta say it right now, but just, you know, give me a clue.
I'll drop it in Trello.
Yeah, place that on in there where it's supposed to be. Yeah. So gentlemen, you guys had a good time?
Yeah.
John, I wanna ask you one question.
Great time, great weekend, great getaway, nice little reset.
Can I ask you my question?
I'm back full of what?
No, go ahead, finish the rest.
That's cool.
How come you post so much food on your Instagram story?
I was eating great. I'm sorry. I was eating great. I don't know, son. Like, I had room service.
I just be wondering, like, You know, like, okay, so my thing be like,
isn't that good to do that?
What? I'm asking a question. So I just be wondering what triggers a nigga to be like, niggas need to see this. That's what I'm saying. Like, for John, it's food. It's a lot of other shit that John do that you'll never know.
Yeah. 100%.
What you will know is that the one meal John eats great, today is
that nigga ain't good, right?
But that's like, I just wonder what in his brain be like, this is the time.
I can't even help it. Is me different on vacation. Like, when I'm on vacation.
And then the other videos make me want to vomit because you be like, you be like this, bro. And I be like,
I'll be all over the place. Nah, you right.
It literally be hold on.
Let me talk about this.
Let me talk about this real quick.
Did y'all like my vlogs?
At the airport when the nigga was behind you?
When I got stuck at the airport.
You thought the nigga wasn't behind you and he's behind you?
Hey, son.
Give me that corner.
This nigga was... I did not see him. I literally did not see him. He was like on the cleaning up staff or whatever. And I literally thought I was in that section by myself. Like, I seen one other person over here. Like
over there?
Like over there. Like over there. I'm over in D7. They're in D6.
Okay.
So I didn't see him and he was cleaning up, but then he sat down to watch TV or whatever for a minute. And I literally thought I was by myself in that section. This is after I came from the vending machine that wouldn't let me vent and
you
shit.
You was pissed off.
Yeah, I was highly.
That joint had a curfew.
That joint had a timer on that bitch.
It had a curfew.
It didn't reopen curfew for you to put money into it until 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. By the time the fucking shops and everything is opening up for them early flights. So yeah, that pissed me off. But at the same time, I walked that whole airport, each terminal, because I was looking for other vending machines and shit.
Oh my goodness!
I'm
just looking at this nigga face, bro.
I know, I'm looking at his face too. But I was looking for other vending machines like that, and I hoped that they were open. And I ain't have nothing else but time. Jay, what else I had to do? I was in that bitch from 9 p.m. to 8:30 a.m.
Did you get one of the cart joints, hey, or you just walked it?
You said what?
You didn't get like a little cart. Wow.
What cart?
You saying a little motorized joints?
Oh, I wish they had those available now. No. I almost got in the wheelchair and started it, but I didn't do
that.
You
was going to kick it?
I was going to wheel myself.
And then roll.
Yeah.
Get a little speed on it.
Yeah.
Like Cuz from Friday.
And slide. Yeah. They ain't had nothing else available, so I just walked the terminal and shit.
So at least you got some calories burned.
Nah, that's what I said. I told people I was working out.
So you was extra hungry because you was looking for food.
Oh, yes. I told y'all. Oh, y'all.
Some niggas the longer you look, if y'all, the hungrier.
If y'all seen it, I was the first in line for Bojangles. I was the first in line for Bojangles at 6 a.m.
You get a Bojangles.
I was in line at 5:54.
Oh man, fuck you. He was in line like they had the J's.
I fucked that shit up.
He was camping out.
Basically.
He camped out for some Bo-Berry biscuits.
Basically. Nigga, I ate everything on that shit.
Too. Oh shit, that's tight, son. All right, so at least you got some food, son.
I mean, I did, and then it was like, you know, my flight still wasn't until 8.
All right, man.
8:30 or some shit.
Like AM?
Yeah.
Oh, but at least you had food on your stomach. You might have got a little drowsy. Then you hit a little ride and you go sleep.
Yeah, nah, I slept the whole 5 hours.
I'm sure.
On the flight, yeah.
And you don't drink coffee enough. So I know you was Gucci.
Yeah,
I don't drink coffee. All right, man. Let's get to some topics.
Go.
So the last time we talked about this gentleman, he was upset with Trey Songz for talking to his woman. His name's Foogiano.
Oh, shit.
They saying the good man is getting 5 years for going on a run.
He did
for the gun charges.
Damn.
So where we last saw him is where he will be for, you know, probably like 2/3 of that at least.
The foreseeable future.
Man, that's fucked up, man.
And I seen like a lot of other news of artists just going to jail.
Yeah, for sure.
In the last week. And it feels like it's a problem.
No, it don't feel like it's it is a problem. It is a problem.
Like I sometimes, you know, when other issues come up and you're like, this feels like a lot more than
everything
usual.
That's going on right now in the hip hop, you know what I'm saying, genre is fucked up, man. It's a lot of shit going on.
A lot of niggas going to jail and dying.
And dying, yeah. It's fucked up.
Like, as soon as they get notoriety, bing.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Foogiano, you know what I'm saying? Like, we talking about, like, some notoriety. He really just starting to boom, boom, boom.
Mm-hmm.
And now, sing, gone.
And then the motherfucking label still make money off that shit.
He's signed to Gucci.
Somebody still
I don't know who Gucci's upstream
is. I was about to say, they don't make no difference.
Yeah, but no, I mean, the music's going to live on. Yeah. Hopefully that puts some on his books and, you know, whatever.
No, I'm sure
it has to happen from there.
It should.
But I think there's a bigger issue in just like, what is going, like, why are we all, like, I think a huge part of it is rapping about what you do. Or like really currently.
You're putting yourself out there.
I feel like, and I ain't saying that about Foogiano, let's be clear.
Very much so.
There's a lot of the cats that are getting locked up, like their bars are.
The shit that happened last week.
Yeah, and it's like very specific.
But not 100%. Detailed. You think they ain't listening? This is.
No, we talked about it months ago. They, Maryland passed it. You can use rap lyrics in court.
They make it so easy.
I mean, Bobby. They make it Bobby so was easy. An example of that, bro.
Back then.
Yeah.
Yeah. They but make we, it so easy. But they still bro, not, come on now.
They still not shop to it.
They shop. They just don't want to listen.
No, I'm not talking about the people doing it. I'm talking about the artists.
That's what I'm talking about.
They got to be sharp to it.
They are. They don't got the right people
they not.
With them.
How
to
are
be
they?
Like, there's no
they
like, be like, come on, don't talk about.
How can that. You? How can you say that the artists are sharp to what's going on, and then they're also the ones rapping it in the lyrics?
No, so I think they sharp too, though, bro.
So the reason I'm saying
you got to know.
Meaning so that they seen this go down multiple times. They
you
have
to.
You
got to know, bro.
At least somebody close to you, whatever, is seeing this.
Who the fuck?
And they're still choosing.
They just think it won't happen to them?
Bruh, how many youngsters you seen go to jail over guns in the video and all these niggas is holding sticks in video still? They don't care, bruh.
But, all right, is it really that bad?
They like, don't care,
real?
Bro.
For real?
I think we don't notice how bad it is because we don't exist in that world for the most part.
I mean, yeah, I'm not in Stickland.
Yeah, exactly. So, but like, to Kay's point, like, whenever I do, like, listen to a rapper, like, when they talk about guns or shit, it's definitely 20 niggas in a video and wife beaters holding guns.
You already talking about guns, nigga. Like, leave them out the video. Fuck you need him in the video for?
And then the cover art is a gun, an illegal one.
Hey. Why you want somebody, if you gonna do something to somebody, why you want them to know you got guns? Anyway.
I mean, there's, yeah.
It don't, it, none of it makes
I mean,
sense,
but this
though.
Is, you know, I guess it's a younger generation, man.
And I'm not saying it like in a way where I'm like, you know what I mean, better than anybody. I'm saying it like, bro, just wise up. Wise
yeah,
up.
No, cool that's what I'm out. Saying. I'm just tired of seeing young niggas with talent go to jail.
Yeah, for sure.
Like, Foogiano was just bubbling, and I've liked him since Gucci said, look at this nigga, I was like, oh. Mm-hmm. As soon as I heard him, I was like, this nigga's nice.
They already got it out for us. Niggas is making it easy.
Yeah, like, I really wanted to see what he was going to do, man.
That's exactly what I'm
niggas
saying.
Niggas making it easy,
that's exactly
but
what
this
I'm
pause
saying.
Is going to hurt. You know what I'm saying? I think he still be straight when he come home, but he got to do the right thing in there, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's still a setback.
He ain't even get a chance to do, you know, too much. He had an impact, but not an impact.
Yeah, not like I think he would've.
Yeah.
Not like I think he would've.
But like I said, there's still, like, money wasted. Money that you grind to get to this tier or whatever. And then...
That's the part I think.
And then when you get there, it's like, you about to wait, like, that could have been divvied up, you know what I'm saying, yeah. Within your family, within who you really trying to do it for, and do it for yourself, and longevity, or what, because really, if you keep on that road, it ain't no longevity.
But, so the one thing I'm going to say about this, because it was, you know what I'm saying, a gun thing, right? If I'm a nigga that was moving around,
keep it funky,
where I need to have guns on me, right?
Go.
And then I become a rapper, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I hire security, right? I feel like me, personally...
Easy.
I'm still not leaving it on you as my security to protect my life. Because you got a life to live too. You got a family. Woo, woo, woo. Okay. I know what the contract is, but when the time comes, I'd rather have it on me.
Okay.
If I'm living that life.
Okay.
So I get trying to have it on you. I don't know what happened with the running and, you know what I'm saying, all of the legality of it, because I ain't looked that deep into it for Foogiano. But a lot of times you hear niggas be like, well, he should have security. Yeah. So, I at a certain level, I might still need to, you know what I'm saying, have a legal jump.
Joe, you gotta do it right, man. These niggas waiting for you to slip. You just gotta do it right.
I'm not saying a legal gun.
I dig what you're saying. I'm just saying, like, motherfuckers just gotta understand they gotta do it right. I don't know why they don't get the fact that you already getting money, more money than these motherfucking police officers. Let's keep it real.
Yeah.
They waiting for you to fuck that up.
Yeah.
Cause all you doing is rapping. That's what they look at it like.
Mm-hmm. You just rapping.
This nigga just talking about shit. We don't even
acknowledge.
We're trying to enforce something against that, and you still talking about it like fuck it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Okay. Yeah. Let's get this nigga.
Specifically.
Yep. Yeah.
Man, just for the young niggas, man, just smarten up. Hold your head. Make sure you keep
smartening up, man.
You looking at shit appropriately. Smarten up, open the market up, as Ho say. This was good to see on a brighter note. Nipsey Hussle's Marathon Clothing is teaming up with Puma for a new collab yet again.
There we go.
For anybody that missed the Marathon Continues, it was like a TMC, wasn't it? Or was it the Victory Lap collection, the last one that they dropped?
I feel like it was.
It was like right after he died.
Nah, it was the TMC jump.
TMC, okay.
Yeah, it was TMC.
So, it's a new collection. All they said was May 7th, 2021, and put up the collab logo.
Okay.
Which is fire.
Right.
And then there's some sketching. There's a T and a Puma suede here.
So, that's this week.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's so good shit.
It's the collab logo T with the TMC flag and
it's gonna sell out
joint, and then the very very nice. It's like a suede, the Puma suede in a all like smoke gray upper, white midsole, nice and classy, and it matches the T perfectly. So that's fly. I like that shit. All right, bet. So new Nip Hussle collection May 7th. What's that, Friday? Cause tomorrow the 5th, right?
Yeah.
So Friday. All right, bet. So Friday, y'all get your bots ready. Goddamn it, here it comes.
Mm-hmm.
All you sneaker fucking crackheads that have ruined the game. No, that's a whole nother podcast. So new music from Cole coming.
Saw that. Yeah.
The project is called The Off Season.
I like it.
Yeah. 514?
That cover look hard. If that's the cover, that shit look hard.
Yeah, that was dope. That was super dope.
Yeah, that shit hard, bro.
Nah, the cover is... That is the cover. Because the parental advisory is there and everything.
Yeah.
That's the cover.
I mean, you know how niggas make last minute adjustments. You know what I'm saying?
It should stick because it's good.
Yeah.
So, new Cole, the 14th. What are you guys anticipating?
Fire.
Who said fire?
John.
Okay.
Me. All right. I think that it's going to be like probably 14 tracks. I'm going to say...
Write this down. We need to talk that.
6 features.
Total?
Total.
You think he's going to feature crazy then for him?
No, because I'm thinking like...
Because he's captain no feature.
I'm thinking like 2 might be on 1 song or something like that. I don't know.
That didn't change the number?
Nah, not really. But,
hey.
But, all right. So, yeah, that's me overanalyzing.
I'm just saying. 6 features.
But, yeah, mostly him for the most part. I think mostly him a little bit.
A little bit?
A little bit.
Mostly him a little bit.
Really wild. I'm thinking
mostly putting on his artist. I don't think it's going to be too many features outside of
Okay, okay, his label. Hold on, hold on. I get where you go. Okay.
Outside of his okay. label, basically. All right. So
well, yeah, because we ain't never seen that one.
It's been a minute for that. It's been a minute.
He could
it's
do that.
So yeah, but yeah.
No, I'm 14. Just I'm listening.
Nah, K, you with me for real. Shut up.
Come on, all right, man. Let me go ahead, man. All right,
but that,
I'm just listening.
But that's it. That's it. I don't know. Hold up. What will be 14 in the pocket?
It's in the pocket. You are you not a member?
Okay, no. But I'm saying
he don't really be here.
I know, but I'm saying minutes wise. I was about to say minutes wise, like as the duration of the album.
Oh, it's he's gonna if the 14 tracks are gonna fit in the pocket, it'll be at the latter end of it. 45 minutes.
Okay. Okay.
He might spill over.
So you said 6 features.
I say 6. Okay. Like in all, yeah.
Okay.
Do you think Cole will give us more? Because a lot of people's critique on Cole's music is that it makes him sleepy.
Everybody do say that.
Do you think that he'll give us more of tempo? Because he can rap that way. Like it ain't like he's not capable.
I don't want him to.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't want him to do that either. That especially.
Yeah,
because if you look at the back at the previous album, mm-hmm. the more up tempo songs were like my least favorite one.
Yeah, yeah. That's actually his mid.
Hmm.
I agree.
Okay.
But there's a market that wants to see him do the other thing.
For sure, but he shouldn't even cater to them.
But
he already got a fan base.
His fanatics.
Yeah.
They
what about shutting up your haters?
Fuck them. That's how you shut them up.
Well, what if he does those and they're not mid anymore? That's what I'm saying.
That's cool.
That's cool, but
what if they're good songs?
I'd rather not hear one, though.
Okay. All right, so Sleepy Cole it is.
Sleepy.
I'm enjoying it. We didn't talk
it.
About your expectations.
Yeah, nah, Cole don't never...
Don't ever disappoint.
Yeah.
What are your expectations?
This is going to sound
my boy.
This is what we're here for.
Uh-oh.
I want you to say it so people can stop calling me a Cole hater.
I think he needs a number one hit single off of this album.
What?
He's not trying to say he don't have
what type of, no.
Sorry to inform you, but that's not going to happen.
No, why do you say that, though? Why do you say he needs a number one single off this?
And what is number one to you?
I mean, there's one metric that measures that.
No, I'm saying, why do you say numbers. He needs that?
Because he's...
To, like...
He's there.
Have him level up? Like...
He's
take him,
there.
Take him to... Over Kendrick or something?
No, he's already... That's what I'm saying. No, he's already where he's supposed to be,
okay,
bro.
I'm just...
Like, what is inquiring. The number one thing going to do? Like, the number one single...
I think that's a big deal for him.
For who?
To stay relevant. Maybe.
What? What
no.
Is that what?
No, bro, what are you saying?
I'm trying to reach for the answer to this question. That's all I'm saying.
I think he needs a number one.
Why?
Because I do.
There's a reason that you think that.
I think because of the things that I just spoke about. Like, because there is the critique that he's a sleepy rapper. Because there is the critique that he doesn't have a classic. Because he's constantly compared... To Kendrick, because he's constantly comparing.
Nah, I ain't heard that he don't got a classic. I ain't heard that.
I have.
I heard it to, what is it, 2014? I heard that was his classic album.
Okay.
They say that.
I would go Born Center, but.
See, we're already debating.
No, but.
And it's just said, us. It's
but,
just
but,
us.
But you're saying.
It's only 5 niggas.
I'm saying he does have a. I'm saying he does have a.
You have a classic.
Yeah,
we're both
one.
Saying
he
that has at least one.
I just, mine would just be Born
so
Center.
So if the two of you think that he. Has debatably won. There's somebody that'll debate he has none.
No, that's different opinions. That does nobody's
some,
opinion
there's
is stone.
There's like a higher consensus classics for a lot of people.
Okay,
I feel you on that. I hear you on that.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, but we don't.
What do you mean by that?
We don't
higher consensus classic. Oh, okay, never mind. I sounded it out.
Go ahead. Yeah.
All right, but back to the why does he need a number one?
He does.
Why?
Because he needs a song of that magnitude.
For whom? You?
No.
Then for whom?
For his career.
What?
Yeah.
He already has a number one, I believe.
Are you crazy?
What's his number one single?
I don't know at the top. Let me know what. This is why I have this computer.
Seriously. Refresh me. If I'm tripping, but I don't think he has a number one.
What you saying? For his career.
It's important.
Why?
Because he's that big of an artist.
Yeah, his albums go crazy too. Like, as far as
that's his championship.
How much they sell.
That's what he's saying. It's like his championship.
Like, in the breath that he's in with artistry, right?
Right.
They all have one.
Go ahead, give it to him. 10 pause.
I will never do that.
What?
But he, you are right, Mr. Coppage. He has 5 top 10 hits, but he does not have a single number one hit according to the Billboard charts.
Wow. Who the fuck niggas number one hit, though?
Niggas of his ilk. I'm not saying everybody needs one. I'm saying, Cole, when you speak of Cole, who do you speak of next? Kendrick.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Who else is on his level?
Drizzy Drake.
Drake.
Okay.
Who else is on his level? Ye.
Oh, no.
Who else is on his level?
So are you talking... Okay, so...
Travis.
My
who else is on his level?
My next question for you. Are you just talking about singles or just projects?
Single.
Okay. Because he has 5... albums that hit number one.
Bruh, that, he don't give a fuck about no single.
I hear you.
Yeah.
I hear you.
I just don't think so.
I think he needs one. And this is, like, he doesn't have to ever do it. This is just my thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
I just want it to be better than the last album.
I think he needs a hit.
That's all I want.
Yeah.
I think that takes him just as bummily dressed into some different meetings with some different clout, some different ideologies, and it puts
that nigga
him...
don't give a fuck about that shit, bro.
No.
That nigga just came out with a shoe.
For what he represents, he does.
He gives a fuck about what?
He represents like a generation of collegiate free thinkers. That's an oxymoron 20 years ago.
So, point?
There's a space that he needs to exist in for a generation.
He does, though.
Not in the spaces he could.
Do you see how the motherfucking world stopped when they figured out he was dropping an album? What are you saying?
I'm
not missing it. You missing it.
So my
the conversation Kanye is in and the conversation Cole is in are different. The conversation that Kendrick is in and the conversation that Cole is in are different.
Are they?
Yes.
I'm trying to figure out the conversations that you want J. Cole to be in that he's not in already.
That's what I'm saying. I'm missing
it. There's a level of access that you get with the financial viability that comes with a number one hit.
Okay, I understand that. But what more does he need to obtain? Right? Not saying that like he has everything, but I think for his career path mm-hmm. and what he's been doing.
Mm-hmm.
I think he might be at a ceiling. I don't think, unless you want like this nigga to join Illuminati or some shit. Like, what?
He's a number one rapper. I mean, I don't know.
I don't understand what other conversations he. I mean, I don't understand what conversations he's
everything
missing.
Y'all are saying is my reason why I'm like, why can't he get a number one hit then?
He don't care about that shit, bro.
I'm not disagreeing with that, but I'm just focusing right now on your point where you said. He needs to be in different conversations.
This nigga's in the conversation.
He's what?
He's in the conversation. And he ain't got a hit. If you want to say that.
I'm trying to figure out. I just need to know what conversations these are.
They're higher dollar conversations.
That's a valid point.
Yeah, and the niggas like they
John, you went outside for 10 minutes.
They use his fucking chill.
3 minutes. It was 12.
I see why he went outside. I got you.
Yeah, he went to go get his
go ahead, load up, man.
His satchel.
Yeah.
But that's look, I want the nigga to get a number one. Y'all act like that's the like plague.
I you want him to need. Get a number one too then.
I do think he needs one.
Right. Who we talking about, John?
Jacob.
I like that you caught that because I caught that too.
Just yeah. making sure
you
okay, know.
I still think he needs it.
I want him to get one too.
I'm not saying you're wrong. That's but good. I just
because of where I think he could be impactful.
He's like,
I think
gonna
he
have
needs to
one
be in a higher
on
dollar
this,
conversation.
On this album.
He's like, gonna... I'd much rather for Hov to be running around with Cole instead of Meek.
I don't think that J. Cole's lack of a number one hit is the reason that he's doing that.
I'm about to say, I think it's separate reasons.
Okay. Because if we're being real, J. Cole's a bigger artist than Meek Mill.
That's exactly. Whoa! Don't you
uh-oh.
Shake your head about that, bro.
Uh-oh.
You cannot be for real.
Ooh. Okay. That's all I got.
Him and Meek mm-hmm. are more relatable. That might have something to do with it, as well as they've been working on the...
Stop it. It's not even close. What stadium tour has Meek Mill headline?
No, himself. I'm talking about relatable, yeah. Like of how they came.
Is that your girl's tour? I mean, is that your tour, your girl's tour? Didn't Drake say that to Meek Mill?
There you go. All right. Now you quoting shit. All right, now.
It was a bad quote, but paraphrase.
No. I got you, though.
Okay. I'm going to let you guys be great.
We're going to have to pose this question then, or a couple questions, I think.
Go on.
This nigga keep doing
I just think that we're going to have to pose a couple questions so we can get...
Oh, the last one, we'll submit one, too.
People's feedback.
Your DJ name's DJ Mimosa Mitt.
That's fine.
Or just Mimosa Mitt.
That's fine.
Oh, that one?
Yeah.
Damn, did I vote for that?
I ain't gonna, which was wild.
Because you were against me on the show.
Listen, I ain't gonna lie. You just set him up though. You lined him up.
How I lined him up
with DJ. You gave him all
the other DJ names are some garbage, bro.
They were.
Those were ones we said.
All right, well, they were garbage.
I mean, that's what I mean.
I don't know. Still, yeah, they were garbage.
Those were literally the ones we said on the show.
I don't think he said nothing that he wanted to say.
These were the arguments.
I don't know, but... But most admit... All
right, we're going to do that again.
And then I said you could phone it in, and the only phone in I got was DJ Take Your Bitchel.
Take Your Bitchel?
Yeah, from a Sop.
That was Sop. Yeah.
DJ Take Your Bitchel.
Yeah, I didn't
and,
like that one.
And that one didn't get any votes.
I didn't like that one.
That was it.
Oh, what's up with the lean?
That wasn't too bad.
Lean that motherfucker like it was. I like that shit.
Slight T.I.
You saw that? Yeah, my man laid the dad hat. I ain't never seen that.
Lean on the dad hat is a wino move.
it definitely wasn't on purpose. I could guarantee you that.
That's that nigga outside the liquor store for sure.
What else you got, man?
Damn, what my man Russia you do? Come on,
I'm not
man.
Russian. No, I'm not Russian.
I'm fucking with you, man.
I'm good.
Oh shit.
How are you?
As Coppa will put it.
Hold on, let me move this Young Mitchell MITMonday into place. Okay.
Peanut, hold up, Peanut.
Why are you yelling?
Your weekend.
Yeah.
How was your weekend, man?
God, it was good.
What'd you do?
I had a good weekend.
What'd you do this weekend, man?
I had my son here.
You had little Z.
Mm-hmm.
And
what? Man, this nigga's phenomenal.
I'm just trying to throw it. Why you was
alright? You funny, man. It's all going to your thing, bro.
I got my house together. You know what I'm saying?
And oh yeah.
Continuation with the house repairs and things. Or
when can we drop a hot 16?
In the studio.
In the studio.
Mm-hmm. It's coming along.
Yeah. You know, it's coming along. You know, I can't. I don't want to keep putting dates on it.
I just want to know.
This mama been.
I'm trying to get at least 3 dye-lines.
No, he been putting the drywall up. He been making that shit soundproof.
Oh, no, this nigga's a whole contractor.
This bama done did. Literally, hold up. I'm going to give you kudos right here, right now. my uncle is, you know, a master electrician or whatever. And John did his lights and shit, like his little dimmers and shit.
Yeah.
And so my uncle came over there to like make sure that he was like up to code and this, that, and third. He was like, all right, so I'm about to start slowing down. I might can hire you to do some shit.
Yeah.
So this band was on point with his shit. Like, just what you was doing? YouTube and watching, learning?
Oh, yeah, man. YouTube University. You already know.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So like my uncle was like, nah, he was like, he probably had like one joint off of a switch or a cord so that the shit wouldn't catch on fire or whatever. Yeah. But yeah, he was like, John was on point.
That's good shit. Mm-hmm.
That's all right.
Been on point.
Wait, knock.
Yeah, knocking you.
Got a hot 16. And I'm writing Tim's verse.
What else? All right. Nah, I ain't gonna keep talking. I'm gonna shut up now.
Nah, it's a podcast. You're meant to talk.
That's a fact.
So, all right, so.
I'm entertained.
If I want to indulge,
in
a little bit of the artist that you work closely with.
Oh, who? Internet?
Internet James.
Oh yeah. What's going on?
What he got cooking, man?
Oh, I mean, you already know he got his project he told you about. He was over here a couple of weeks ago.
Facts.
Still working on that. He hasn't given me no final
mm-hmm. anything, but you know, we got some copies. It's there.
Can
we just waiting on the final package?
Can we play some exclusive? Not yet.
Not yet.
All right,
I don't want to put it out there yet.
That's what I was reaching for real. I'm gonna shut up.
Okay. Yeah, not yet.
All right, I'm gonna shut up.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
There,
this Vegas Anderson right here.
The Anderson hour.
Vegas Anderson.
I'm still on LA time. I'm tired of shit. I ain't gonna lie.
We can tell.
It's cool. It's cool.
Mr. Bojangles.
It's cool. Mr. Bojangles.
Yeah.
Because I was first in line.
Yeah. I was first in line for the Bojangles.
He was tap
dancing. Last in line for the pop.
Ching-a-ling, jang-a-ling. Shut up, son.
Ching-a-ling. Whoa. All
right.
That ain't what I said. Hey, he's on him remixing.
Yeah, I just left it alone, man.
Yeah, that's ain't him. Don't even worry about it. Don't look.
Don't
worry about
don't
it.
Don't go with it.
Don't right. even worry about it.
Right.
Young Mitchell, yes. MITMondays. What yes. it is, brethren?
Morray. He are you pronouncing his name correctly? Is that the proper?
Well, that's what we're gonna say.
Okay.
Morray.
Yeah.
Hey Siri.
He doesn't have a choice.
This nigga all the chain, cuz. I ain't gonna lie.
That's all I was about to ask Siri for the right name. I bet.
Yeah. He dropped his, he called it his debut mixtape.
Okay. All right.
And
what's it called?
Street Sermons.
All right. You guys heard it here first. All right. Street Sermons.
13 tracks.
Uh-huh.
Mm.
36 minutes.
Okay, there in the pocket.
He has been listening to the Baseline Podcast.
Yes, sir.
Prior to this mixtape release,
uh-huh.
He would just put out singles.
Yeah, five of them.
Five, and I was
six.
Like,
six.
And I was like, this is actually a good way to do it.
Yeah.
And so, I get to the project on Wednesday, and it's a little disappointed, quite frankly.
Oh, it was underwhelming.
It
oh,
was.
Man. Oh nah.
It was.
We ain't heard Young Mitchell do it like that, man.
And it hurt my heart. It really did.
Yeah. Because that was your guy, right?
It's still my guy.
Yeah.
I'm not going to abandon ship. I'm not a quitter.
Right. No, yeah.
I got you. But he just missed the shot.
Yeah, it just... So, I think... Even though I said it was a good way to promote your album, you know, have the singles.
Right.
I was kind of bored because I heard over half the songs already.
Oh, yeah, that ain't good.
Because it was six of them out, there's 13 total tracks. Yeah,
if you're going to do that, you might as well put out all new shit.
Well, that, and then the thing was, like, you know how, okay, if you're going to do that, like, do your thing, right? Mm. But this would still be some B-sides that, like, bang.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It just felt really redundant.
Yeah.
Mm.
Like, the subject matters, like, all like the joints that I hadn't heard, he was still telling me about the struggle and ramen noodles and shit, and I was just like, I get it. Mm. I get that.
Right.
But is there any, there's not a girl you like, or you've never like wanted to be a hoop star or a football player or like nothing else happened in your life?
Yeah, it was interesting because like those questions that you just asked, like I watched a couple of his interviews. He's a very entertaining guy. Like
the subject matter was just very one-sided.
It's very right. And it's kind of vague too.
Well, that too. Also, you know, the struggle that he speaks of and the person he presents himself as are a little juxtaposed. They're very opposite. They're very like, one's this guy. Like, him in interviews is very, like, jovial.
I mean, people are happy in the struggle.
Yeah, but the struggles he talk about sound like he a real, like, you know how, like, Jim Jones is kind of a happy nigga too, but I feel like he'll hurt you. You know what I'm saying? Like he don't give me them vibes, and that's neither here nor there.
Yeah, I'm about to say you can't really say that. Most of the happy motherfuckers, they're the motherfuckers that'll knock your shit off. Real shit.
They don't
give a fuck about showing that they happy.
I just needed more subject matter. That's my bottom line.
Yeah,
that's it.
John, yeah, nah, it was
one of y'all hit your mic cord or don't. Don't worry about it. We're good. Never mind.
There you go.
See, I said,
he told me to. Then I said,
don't, didn't I? And then he said, I'm going to do it anyway.
Yeah,
you
know. So, right, never mind. As far as dialogues,
yeah.
It hurts my heart to do this.
Mm-mm.
We're going 2-5.
I knew he was about to do it, and I agree.
2-5.
2-5 on this?
2-5.
Yeah, because okay, so think about it.
I don't
right?
think I heard you do that one. Since
there's six
on.
Songs on the yeah. project, right?
13 songs on the project.
I mean, there's six songs on the project we heard before it came out. Mm-hmm. We like those songs. The rest of them did nothing for us.
Damn.
At least for me.
Nah, it didn't. It didn't do anything. I didn't. So, I didn't.
But, point, but the six songs are.
They're good.
Okay.
I'm and not the, saying they're all A1. They're good. They're
and
good
the other though. Songs sound exactly like that.
Damn. And so it was just like subject matter, melodies, like everything. So, yeah, we're at a 2.5.
Beats too?
Jai like
the
yeah,
same.
Mo.
Damn.
Yeah, in the most DMV of ways.
He probably need better production then.
Yeah,
something that's gonna bring something else
he
up.
He needs not even like the beats. He needs a producer.
Yeah.
Like, a real live like
show somebody that's gonna sing
one
with
of them. He need one of them. And then he could go crazy.
Yeah, because he said he's only been rapping for like 2 years or some shit like that.
Yeah, he just need he like it. There's something there. It just needs to be honed.
Yeah.
But this one, 2.5.
So that's not so like, I know this ain't. So what would you call what he does? Because you just said he's only been rapping for 2 years. But would you call it rapping?
It's weird because it's like it's harmonies.
It's Destiny's Child.
Yeah, I don't think like what they do now. I don't
it's
think
it's
like
whatever. It's very it's similar. Not, it's very similar to Rod Wave.
It's Destiny's Child. Y'all gonna cut the shit.
Nah, I know what you're talking
about.
What
you're talking about. We're not disagreeing with you.
It's them.
Okay. Yeah,
that's what these niggas are doing.
Yeah.
Sing rapping.
Destiny's Child is better than all of you niggas at that shit too.
All right, see, I ain't say that.
I got hit his shit. I got hit. Yeah. I can't speak on it because I ain't hit shit. So.
If they wanted to do this, they could do this, and it would sound crazy.
So wait. So are we gonna play some of that shit tonight, okay. or are we going to just not because he ain't he only got the 2.5?
Like it's threes and up get played. Is that what we doing?
I mean, like
are we segregating.
Me, but then, like, can't be like that. That ain't right. That
give
ain't
me,
right,
give
man.
Me something. I'm
asking.
I ain't
asking.
Never seen you be foul
give me,
like
give
that.
Give me something.
Man.
Give me something.
Give what?
I ain't never seen you be foul like that. You said, "Nah, we ain't playing none of that shit."
I didn't say, first of all, I didn't even say that.
Nah, no, you shook your head. That's all.
But because it was like, what am I going to play?
See, so yeah, you were alluding to not playing shit.
Because all of it's already out as singles, it'd be different if we could give you something.
Give us
the other joint.
Ones
that
Yeah. One or two.
We don't like them.
Just, okay, let's just hear one.
One.
Yeah, all one.
Right. Hey.
Which one? Tim?
Let's see. Let me make sure I'm not crossing over with the singles, because I don't remember the names exactly. Let's go Nothing Now.
Okay. You guys ready?
Nothing Now. Yeah.
Oh, shit, you sure say Expect Nothing.
Expect Nothing, you get nothing.
He don't know that. he didn't know his shirt said that.
Oh, no, I like this beat, though.
I'm gonna look in the camera.
Tell me I'm wrong if I pack my shit and leave. So tired of hearing all the things that you don't need. But I know the only thing you need. You too blind to see. So many people, they would love to have a spot. Don't wanna hear it, you been fucking up a lot. Supposed to be solid as a motherfucking rock. I'm only sad because it turns out that you're not. Really believe it or not, that is a motherfucking meteor rock. Pop on a dick, make a buzz off the clock. Had some punch, she sucked dick like a thot. She was being deceiving and being misleading. Every name on her phone is a motherfucking god. Bitch, she got so many brothers, a mama and daddy. Might be fucking round the clock. That's what I told myself, but I love the bitch. That's why I cuffed the bitch. Now I'm by myself. It's mob and glow. Ain't got time no more. Taking off the world. You fool the streets, and I was sad to see how you embrace the block. If you find another nigga, he can't do it like I can. Money was your motivation. Walk the plank for a grand. Looking foolish, acting clueless like you just don't understand. Thought you was moving like a bumper, wasn't blowed by a man. Believe you trying to play me. That's what I give her, always trying to save. Who don't really need the saving. Leave after you have nothing in your savings. Tell me I'm wrong if I pack my shit and leave. So tired of hearing all the things that you don't need. But I know the only thing you need is me. It's just sad cause you're too blind to see. So many people, they would love to have your spot. Don't wanna hear it, you've been fucking up a lot. Supposed to be solid,
your shit cut off today. Wanna do that, they be paying you to do that thing we did every day. But you blew that, but you already knew that, so girl, get out my face. It's a different time, it's my time to shine. I just got the role, you not mine. So don't waste your time, act like you don't know me. That nice guy that you used to like, I no longer know him. Held him down and ripped out his heart. I feel bad for homie, since you've been away. Since you've been away, it's been only fuck you. Tell me I'm wrong if I pack my shit and leave. So tired of hearing all the things that you don't need. But I know the only thing you need is me. It's just sad 'cause you're too blind to see. So many people, they would love to have a spot. Don't wanna hear it, you've been fucking up.
Yeah, yeah. That was Morray. That joint was Nothing Now. Is that correct, Tim?
Yes.
That yeah, Morray. Nothing Now.
Okay. I do understand, bro.
He's talented as shit.
I definitely see. Some different things with his voice and all that good stuff.
He gets a little redundant.
Yeah, yeah. Once he do that, though, it'd be set.
It's early.
Because he is talented.
Yeah, but we just being honest about the project. Like, overall, I still think he's super dope.
I'm still going to play Quicksand. Like every day, but
man, Quicksand was something special.
Nah, that joint there.
That's what's up.
John, you don't know about no Quicksand, that. Man.
That's why he said that's what's up.
That's what's up.
So, Deuce Fives?
Yeah.
All right, appreciate you, buddy.
Deuce Fives.
Stand on that island together.
Deuce Five.
Without further ado, gentlemen, unless we have any half a bars, I can get right into new music.
I do have a half a bar topic.
Oh, let's go.
Are you invested in cryptocurrency?
I am not.
Wow. Interesting.
I am too.
Are you in Doge? Dogecoin? How you say it?
Yeah. Dogecoin.
Doge.
Yeah.
I don't know. But it's going crazy lately.
Yeah, it's been going on. Yeah.
A lot of cryptocurrencies have. Like Doge. There's another one called like Ethereum. That one's Ethereum. See, I don't know. I just know how to invest.
I know how to read it. I don't know how to say it.
I know the ticker symbol.
It was just
interesting to see. And then with Dogecoin, Elon Musk has been championing that one. And apparently
advocator
when he goes to SNL, I think it's this coming week, they're supposed to have a skit. So they're saying it's gonna go to the moon again.
For real?
Yeah.
Just because he's on TV.
So invest more, you're saying?
I mean, I don't know. I'm good with my investments.
You good with where you at? Oh, yeah.
It's
going to
let it rock.
Yeah, let's let it rock.
I throw it up. Where is that now?
Where is that now?
Yeah, let's see.
58. Yeah. Oh, boy. I'm doing even better.
Yeah.
A share?
Oh, it's 58 now? 58 cents per Dogecoin. Oh, man.
A share?
Yeah.
Break it down.
I get it, but for my banker brain for a second.
Yeah.
It's a fucking share.
Yeah,
share. It's a coin. It's a thick. It's a thimble. It's a whatever. Sure.
How'd you slip that one in there?
it's a this. Like, how much is one? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. What the fuck?
How did he slide that in there?
So.
Because that's how fucking minutia that is to me. Like, I don't give a fuck what it's called. It's 59 I just want right one. Now.
How much is one? You think people should invest?
It's going up. 59 cents.
If you want to. But I was just saying.
Stay.
Right.
Nothing that you're not
willing to
lose. 100%.
Yeah.
I mean, that's always
you
how it is.
So 59 cents is high.
Yeah.
Yeah, it started.
I got it at 38.
7 cents or 4 cents.
January was
9
cents.
Right.
But like, okay. Just new guy here, right? It's fucking 59 cents.
Nah. I mean, you can get in right
now.
Okay,
so let's say I buy 20 of them.
Yeah, right. But see, that's not the issue. It's people who are spending $2,000 they were supposed to spend in rent because they think they're going to change
their they're idiots. Yeah. We're not. No. I don't think those are our constituents.
What happens if I buy?
No, I'm following you. I hear what you're saying.
No, you got a better deal.
Go.
I got $15.
That's play money. That's money you're willing to lose.
Right. Right. And then it does what Bitcoin does.
Right.
Did or is doing.
Yeah.
Well, see,
that's a bad buy.
But that's when we're going into understanding how it works and why it will never reach that price point.
That's fine.
Yeah.
But if it gets to like a dollar,
It's good.
Oh, we love
it. I'm cool with, like, possibly. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's, for me, it's penny stocks. It's mm-hmm. like, I don't give a fuck. You know what? Sure. Whatever's in my cash app, I'm probably gonna put.
No, it. Listen, savings. I get what you're saying, because that's what I was thinking.
But you got, you got to watch.
Even though, like, Bitcoin right now is $50,000, you don't have to spend $50,000 to get into Bitcoin. You can spend $10 into Bitcoin. It's made to be broken up in practice, like all crypto is. That's why it's.
All right, I'm not doing this science lesson.
But just be careful.
I'm just saying, 59 cents, nigga. I can't get anything else for 59 cents. It might be worth it.
You get a piece of candy, maybe a piece of gum.
What do you want, son?
I'm telling Rod to open the door.
Oh, okay. Do we have any other half of Barringtons?
The Wizards are playing good basketball.
They are.
Yeah.
Yeah, they are.
You saying playing good basketball?
Yeah. No, Russ has been going crazy.
Why? This was it.
Russ has been like triple doubling his ass off.
Yeah, he averaged triple double again for the fourth season in a row.
Yeah, he's,
and the season's not even over yet, so that's crazy.
Yeah, there we go. Let's get the money. What's good, bro?
Lit.
Oh, shit, that nigga on the phone. You could have went on the other side, nigga.
But, yeah, so, yeah, hopefully we'll be getting some playoff basketball in the district.
Okay. Yeah. Are you going to go?
Yeah.
Because you vaxxed up?
Yeah.
Vax boy, what you going to do? What you going to do when they come for you?
You niggas are ridiculous.
All right.
I appreciate the support, sir.
I mean, little gotta support her.
He ditched you.
Yeah, he abandoned sides real quick.
But same time, K kind of ditched me.
How?
Because if y'all are the middlemen, we have to be, I don't know, whatever this is.
The outsiders.
The outer men.
The outsiders.
The outers.
And we were supposed to stick together on the bad outers. Boys.
On the bad boys?
Yeah. But I know that's more of a me thing than you.
Yeah.
I know that. Y'all know your personality.
Because I was thinking... So you some think, more shit in my head while y'all was singing that.
So here's some crazy. Here's a good question.
What's that?
Who do you think is more similar, the middlemen or the outsiders?
Oh shit.
Who's more similar, the middlemen or the outsiders? Each other.
I about to say to you gotta say that too. But
I think the outsiders.
You think we're more similar than y'all two are?
Actually, you know what's crazy? The scale
is very, opposite. Yeah.
Very opposite for each.
Yeah.
On both sides.
On both sides.
It's very optimistic. And it's at times.
See, when he says stuff
it's that time.
I don't know what island he exists on.
See,
No. Listen, you got to decipher. You know what I'm saying?
It's at times.
You got to decipher.
I can't read that.
It's really at times.
I only know a few languages.
We need Rob Markman.
Because me and Kay sometimes be like, yeah, I bet.
What?
And that's just, I bet.
Look,
it's just that. It's so simple.
See?
It's so simple.
See?
But then Tim might care more. He might care more about the subject.
Just quit.
It just depends.
But that's not that answered nothing with the question.
You don't think so?
No.
Because who are more similar?
Because you're a middleman. So we're only comparing and contrasting these two compatibility versus ours.
All right,
no,
so
not about compatibility.
Look, that's weird. It's not compatibility.
Similarity.
100%. Yeah.
That's weird.
Oh yeah, that was a poor choice.
I was waiting for somebody to correct that.
Yeah, I'm glad.
That was a poor choice.
I'm glad he did.
Compatibility.
But at the same time,
Tim, I'm not compatible.
Tim, first off, let's just take it all the way back.
Let's take it all the way back.
Let me cut you off. I brought you in here.
No. Who you used to hit first? Who you probably hit now?
Ooh. Oh shit, you a traitor.
I'm not a traitor. I'm just saying. It's not that deep.
Why you go there then?
This shit might end in therapy. I ain't going to y'all bad. Tread lightly, gentlemen.
I think that Tim probably will hit Jason for whatever he might need. Possibly before he hits me.
Mm-hmm. Why am I in the conversation?
I'm about to say what just happened.
Me and Kay talk on our frequent
where are we going?
All right. No. Because you fucking it up. I'm deciphering what you're saying.
All right, go ahead.
So he's basically saying it's like the middleman and then it's the outsiders. But then you got, my fault, then you got
the wingman.
Right here, and then right here.
Left wing, right wing.
That's what he's saying.
And I There's nothing wrong with that.
Wait. I understand that.
They didn't answer the initial question.
Because everyone on this show is friends. Right. So all of that exists.
No. I get what you're saying. But you're going to come back to the question.
I asked a simple question.
Okay, I took it somewhere else. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I don't know what happened. It did sound like a therapy session, though.
I'm shutting up again.
No, because the therapy session is, here it is. Oh, shit. Here we go.
Yeah.
The reason Tim is more comfortable hitting me is because I'm going to do what I'm doing and saying I'm doing.
Oh, shit. I'm out of this.
Go.
I'm back in the waters now.
No, go on.
I'm out.
It's quicksand. No, go on. Go on.
Go ahead. Y'all got to hash it out. Fuck it.
It's here now, bro. Listen.
Linda. Listen.
Niggas got responsibilities. Responsibilities. I said that appropriately.
Yeah, I love it.
Niggas got responsibilities.
Mm-hmm. Right?
When Tim needs a helping hand, maybe it's just that my responsibilities better align with the window of time he needs.
Granted.
That was a good way to say that.
I like that. It's easy. Yeah.
So I don't think that comes into question in a debate about the middlemen versus the outsiders.
Mm. I agree. And I wasn't putting nothing on.
Oh man, come on. It's too much explaining going on. Yeah, damn.
Middleman is who we are, the outsiders.
So we still haven't got an answer to my question. Right, we're gonna move the fuck on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. It's time for new music.
New music.
We have a whopping 2 tracks.
Let's go. Knock, you gonna play a track too? I'm putting you on the spot.
No, we talked about that.
Yeah, we did.
I got some.
All right. Oh, yeah.
All right, bet.
Local, national. Well, local, regional, national.
What, his?
It's national.
His, right. I'm sure his is national. He's a fucking DJ.
He's a fucking DJ.
A plethora of music in front of him on a regular basis.
Mm-hmm.
So we going to start. Hey, I like the gesture. Use your hands.
Hey, chill, Slime.
Gotta give him a reason to go to YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
That's a Fendi. That's real. Nigga, we on YouTube now. He can use his hands.
That's real.
John was doing interpretive dance.
What did I miss?
What were they laughing at?
Was the nigga doing something crazy? John was guiding a whole airplane then.
Beep.
No bullshit.
Yeah, nah, we gonna do that.
Beep.
Oh man, this
y'all love the hood, man.
Oh, I don't know.
You love the hood.
Man. Y'all love the hood, man.
Shut up.
You
ever
head out?
I'm on LA time still. Shut up.
You was never in LA.
I mean Vegas time. Whatever. Same.
We're
shit.
Later than they are. You should be more.
No bullshit, right. Man.
I don't sleep, period. So
exactly.
So it's all bullshit.
Thank you very much, Captain Anderson.
All right. Well, I'm fucking tired today.
He called your shit malarkey.
God damn it.
Malarkey. All right, let's get into that's coming back. This is Let, right?
Yes.
Did we decide on that? Let.
Yeah, L-E-T.
This track is called Virtuous Woman. The artwork is amazing.
Yeah.
Let's get into it. Yeah, yeah. That was Let, Virtuous Woman. I like that.
I like her, man. She different.
No, she's super dope.
I like
she
that.
She is different. This artwork is fire once yeah, more.
I like that.
This joint is so dope. I don't know who did it. I'm sure it's
she. And you see her said, her name is L-E-T, Let.
All caps.
Okay.
Yes. So shout out to her.
What's this?
Let's get back to Trizzle. What's next? No, wrong start. Wrong joint. Okay. I got two more tracks because Tim might have let us down.
You got two more tracks?
Tim might have let us
I got
down.
One. Damn, y'all met you.
Hold up.
And then okay. So we got three one. More tracks. All right, I'm gonna do two. And
damn, then damn, Slim.
Y'all heard that?
The fuck?
I told you that was Uncle Anderson. Nigga, whole life just broke on camera. and we adding sound effects when that happened.
That shit loud as a motherfucker. I ain't gonna lie.
Y'all heard it for real?
Nah, if that motherfucker on the mic, they gonna hear too. Damn. Shit.
Hey, nah, we need back crack noises. Let me rename marker. Back crack noises.
Oh, yeah. You got to amplify that so they hear that
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, yeah,
no.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
No, no.
Yeah, that's what you gonna do.
I always try to.
Oh, man.
Sorry, bro.
That's nuts.
But that was to get the body off the ground because the front was on springs. You see how that worked? Right?
That come shit on, is man. Don't nuts. Play with me.
Man,
y'all should be able to do that.
What?
I feel like there's something wrong with y'all. Y'all can't crack your neck and shit. Like,
who whatever. Said they can't crack their neck, bro?
But I'm saying your shit sound like it broke.
Yeah, no bullshit. Mm.
Your shit sound like it broke.
You need to seek professional
your shit
help.
Shouldn't sound like that, bro.
I get acupuncture. I get massages.
I don't give a fuck about what you get.
Massages from your sister.
Your neck.
I don't even like that.
Don't
you
even
said
say that,
that
like that.
I don't even say that.
Don't even say that like that.
Oh, you're wrong.
Come on, Slime. Come on, man.
No.
You better correct that shit right now
like,
while we on the mic, man.
I can't even play the next song because you said it like that.
She's a fucking masseuse.
Yeah, professional. She has her own business.
Yeah, 100%. And I support Black.
There we go.
And that's where we at with it. Damn, yeah, my bad. Nah, you dab me up?
Nah, that's fucked up.
All right, whatever.
Hey, you better get into your house quick. don't linger.
Not fucking with Kay tonight. Sorry, boss.
Don't linger around outside the show.
I'm not in my own background. I mean, backyard. Nope.
Did you play the Saba one?
Oh, no, I didn't play the Saba. The Saba joint should work.
Yeah, Saba.
Why John's getting queued Saba. Up? Let's go.
Yeah, let me play the Saba joint.
Oh my God, don't let us down.
It's a bad week of music, huh?
Don't let us down.
No, I just didn't want to play a song called Entice after John talked about getting a massage from K's sister.
Yeah, man. God damn.
But we're going to play Saba Abraha Entice. I tried to get us out of there and there was no other option. So here we go.
John about to get stabbed up.
I ain't going to lie. That made me steam high,
Kay,
bro.
Stop.
I ain't going to lie. The placement.
Relax.
You know it was wrong. You know it was
all
wrong.
Right. All right.
I'm not the same, not in the slightest. I know it may seem, but I'm not the same. I get caught in the rain when I'm pouring all of me. Back in the day, I would have been drowning. Now it's a parade, 'cause I'm not the same. Me without you. Funny how things do change. It's not too hard to say. You're not too hard for me. You don't entice me, no. You don't entice me. It's not too hard to say. You're not too hard for me. You don't entice me. Hey, you don't entice. It's hard to let go. I know you didn't see this coming. Except it's your own. Fast in it, then get stepping. Won't say it twice, you ain't get my message. I told you once, you ain't what I like. Won't say to fight, you can't forget it. Growing without you, it's a new face. You say, you see me without you. Funny how things do change. It's not too hard to say. You're not too hard for me. You don't entice me, no. You don't entice me. It's not too hard to say. You're not too hard for me. You
don't entice me. Hey, you don't entice. It's not too hard to say. You're not too hard for me. You don't entice me, no. You don't entice me. It's not too hard to say. You're not too hard for me. You don't entice me. Hey, you don't entice.
Yay. That was Saba Abraha.
All right, now.
That job is called Entice.
That shit is enticing. I like it.
Hey, yeah. This motherfucker is shake, girl.
Yeah. Now, Knock, what you got? Knock?
Yes, sir. Last but certainly not least, DJ P Knock got a track for us. You going to tell us what it is? You just about to bust niggas in the head.
Nah, I'm about to bust niggas in the head.
Okay, come well, on, then here Knock. It is. New Let's music. Go. DJ P Knock. Let's go.
Might not be new move to
I'm on. But you want me home. I get you what you want.
Knox, I just wanna make sure y'all know.
Baby, I'm acting. You held me up and I was down and out. But I don't want you waiting around for me. I don't want you waiting too long.
She hold me down like gravity. We on the front page of them blogs. Would you be mad at me if the whole world knew this we was on? Would be tragedy. My niggas be globe trotting like travel teams. You always in my travel dreams. Lace up 2-3 stripes and I'm gone. But you just want me home. Shorty hit my jack like what the f*** you doing? Bitch, I'm all alone.
You gon' press me now?
Bitch, you gon' stress me out and cuss me out? I had my fair share of women's feelings. Don't catch me.
I got one more. Shit. Damn. Crowd tonight, God.
What's
up, Taco Tuesday?
I know the track, bro.
All right. It's my last drink.
Come on, you with the music.
Let's go now.
Fuck all this.
We gone.
That do sound like that.
Yeah, now that was hard. I like that shit. Yeah, that.
Bye.
Okay, DJ P-Knock. There we go, sir. Thank
good
you.
Good one, Knock.
I appreciate you, sir.
Way to take us out.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Gentlemen, this has been the Baseline Podcast, episode 159. I believe we'll call it Las Vegas.
Call it
Lost Vegas.
Vegas. Yeah, I like that.
Lost Vegas.
Yeah.
It's good. It's good.